يثبت الله الذين آمنوا بالقول الثابت في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة.
The question أين الله? Where is Allah? It is not part of Aqeedah. It is not part of our creed and Iman. So if we're going to answer first, this question shouldn't be asked based on Aqeedah and Iman.
Assalamu alaikum. In this video, I'll be refuting those foolish people who say Allah is not above the throne, rather He's nowhere or He's everywhere. So let's look at what Allah said about Himself and what the Messenger said about Allah and what the Sahaba said and what the Salaf said. Allah stated, أَأَمِنْتُمْ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاءِ? Do you feel secure from the one who is in the Sama? Sama means in Arabic what is above, or it means the height. So Allah says He is in the height, He is above. Then He repeats, Am amintum man fis sama? Or do you feel secure from the one who is above, the one who is in the height? So Allah affirmed that He is in the height. Ar-Rahmanu ala al-arsh istawa. The most merciful is established above the throne. So where is Allah? He's established above the throne. Allah said, إِنَّ رَبَّكُمُ اللَّهُ الَّذِي خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ فِي سِتَّةِ أَيَّامٍ ثُمَّ اسْتَوَى عَلَى الْعَرْشِ. Indeed, your Lord is Allah who created the heavens and the earth in 6 days, then established Himself above the throne. Many times Allah says in the Quran, ثُمَّ اسْتَوَى عَلَى الْعَرْشِ. Then He established Himself above the throne. So where is Allah? He rose above the throne. That's where He is, established above the throne. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he asked a slave girl once, this is in Sahih Muslim, he asked her, where is Allah? She said, fis sama, in the height, above. He said, free her, for she is a believer. So the Prophet affirmed what? Allah is in the sama. As you see here, the hadith in Arabic, it says, fis sama, he is in the sama, which means he is above, or he's in the height. Sama is different from samawat. Samawat means heavens. Sama means what is above. It means in the height. So they've translated it here as in heaven, but actually it should be in that Allah is above, or He's in the height. Okay? Another hadith. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Ar-Rahman will be, or the merciful, I should say, sorry. The merciful will be shown mercy by Ar-Rahman. Be merciful to those on the earth, and the one in the sama will have mercy upon you. Translation, which says in heaven, but in the Arabic, again, it says fis sama, in the height. So actually, this should be translated, the one in the height will have mercy upon you. The one above will have mercy upon you. So where did the Prophet say Ar-Rahman is? Above, in the height. The Sahaba, let's look at what they said. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, he said, the kursi, the footstool, is the place of the 2 feet, and the size of the throne cannot be known. So how did Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu conceive of the ayah, Allah is established above the throne? He believed it literally, that He is actually established upon or above the throne. Abu Musa al-Ash'ari, another companion, he says, the footstool is the place for the 2 feet, and it creaks as a saddle creaks. So how did the Sahaba believe Allah was above the throne? Literally, that He is actually above the throne. Similarly, Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, another companion, narrated, between the first heaven and the one above it is a distance of 500 years. Between each of the heavens is a distance of 500 years. Between the seventh heaven and the kursi, the footstool, is a distance of 500 years. Between the footstool and the water is a distance of 500 years. And the throne is above water. Allah is above the throne, and nothing whatsoever of your deeds is hidden from Him. So what did Ibn Mas'ud believe? He actually believed Allah is above the throne. Let's look at what the Salaf said.
Bukhari is one of them. This is the book of Bukhari, Khalq Af'al al-Ibad. This book, Bukhari, proves that Allah is over His throne. And narrating from the Salaf, Tabi'een, that they debated the Jahmis, and it appeared to them that they believe that there is no God over His throne.
So this proves that the Salaf believed Allah is actually above the throne. And in fact, they clearly here even debated people who were saying he's not above the throne. And at the end of the debate, when these Jahmi people, they did not accept that Allah is above the throne, the Salaf said, it seems as if these people don't believe there is a God above the throne. So what did the Salaf believe? That Allah is actually above the throne?